What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about the aerodynamics of the Mercedes-Benz Vision EQXX. And the reason why is because it has one of the lowest drag coefficients ever. Its drag coefficient is 0.17. And to give you an idea of how low that is, the average car these days is around 0.26 to 0.28. And this is a concept car, but there are a lot of different features on here that make the drag a lot lower than a regular car. And we're going to be going through them, and there are actually quite a few that are quite secretive, actually. So let's start off with the most obvious one, which is the roof. So we see here how the roof really slopes down from very far up from the car. Like literally, once you get to the driver's point, the roof starts to come down. And what that means is that the flow will stay attached quite nicely because there isn't really any sharp curve here. It just clearly flows down and hits the rear and then it goes into the wake. Now, in terms of the front, it is a little bit blunter, but that is still pretty decent and it's not as bad as what it could be if it was a little bit more upright. So in addition to the rear, which is reducing the wake size, which reduces the pressure drag mainly, the car also has a very small back. And this is a very important note because the rear of a car is one of the main contributors to the drag of the car. And the reason why is because if you look at a regular car, you have the front and back. The difference in pressure on the front surface compared to the back surface is what creates mostly the pressure drag. So if you have a very small rear, you don't have a very big area here that is seeing low pressure. And really whatever back you have, you are going to be getting low pressure because there's going to be a wake here. The only way to reduce this to almost nothing is by making the back go into a point, so almost like an airfoil trailing edge. So having the rear very small here reduces the area that the low pressure is acting over, which reduces the pressure drag. In addition to that, they have a very sharp rear back here, which this what that means is the flow comes along, hits this rear, then separates very cleanly. That makes the car more stable and also usually reduces the wake. Now, in addition to that, we also see if we go upstream at behind the front wheel, we get this sort of gap here. So what is this doing? So we have this wheelhouse here, and this goes for really any wheelhouse, but predominantly for the front wheels. So you have air going into the front wheelhouse, which they have managed to reduce how much free volume there is by increasing the size of the tires. You can see that the tires in this picture and this picture take up most of the wheel housing. That's very good for reducing drag. You don't have a lot of volume for the air just to bounce around and increase the drag. But there is still some volume and there is still some air going in here. And when you get to the rear of the house, it's going to want to come out. And what happens if it does come out is that it will then start to mix with the flow that comes around the side of the car and increase the wake size around this region. That increases the drag and makes the car less efficient. So by putting these gaps here, the flow can then escape the wheelhouse through this region, which means that the flow coming around the front can suck more to the car and reduce the wake of the car. And then as you go downstream, these two streams start to mix a little bit, as we can see here with this sort of cutout here, and then it hits the rear wheel. So that reduces drag as well. In addition to this, we see the rear arch here. See how nicely tapered and sloping down it is. They could have made this a lot more aggressive or even not have it at all. But the reason why they have this is because you have some flow coming over the front of the car, and we'll get into a second where this is coming from, likely. The flow is coming over the front of the car, and it gets funneled down. So we can see in this picture and this picture just how much it slopes down. So pretty much everything about the back of this car is really focusing on shooting all the flow into the wake to reduce the wake size, which then reduces the drag of the car. And this is what this rear arch is also doing. In addition to this, we have the diffuser, and this diffuser can also extend. And that's a really cool feature for two reasons. One, you can make the diffuser more aggressive, which means that you can reduce the wake size. And two, you can control what velocities, what speeds you're traveling at. This will start to deploy it and by how much. So when you go to faster speeds, you might want to deploy this more. And that also helps with downforce, which helps keep the car attached to the road. Now, in terms of the front, let's go to this picture here. We see this nice, it's a really nice curve here. This is also an air curtain. So what this means is the flow comes along, hits the front of the car, then goes through around the side. And without this air curtain, usually it will just flow around to the wheel. And that results in a fairly big wake popping out. By having this air curtain, the flow gets funneled in through here. And you can also change the velocity of the flow if you want to by changing the cross-sectional areas. but just let's say there's no change. Even still, the flow comes through and then it gets funneled around the tire and reduces the wake of this front wheel, which reduces the drag of the car overall. And we'll see in a little bit just how much effort has been put into reducing the drag of the cars of the tires overall. We've already seen how they've taken up a lot of the wheelhouse. We've now seen the flow coming around the tire has been optimized. The flow coming out of the wheelhouse has been optimized, but there's even more that we'll get into in a little bit. Now, in addition to this, we can see that the roof also tapers fairly nicely as well, as we mentioned. If we go to the next picture, we see up here, this is a bird's eye view, and the roof tapers from the door upwards. Now, this is a feature that has two positive effects for the drag coefficient and the drag of the car overall. First of all, for the drag coefficient, we see that because it is nicely tapered, the flow will follow a lot nicer and reduce the drag, and reduce the wake. But because it is tapered, it means that this car has a smaller cross-sectional area, which means that in terms of the overall drag, there's less cross-sectional area, which means that the drag drops as well. It's a value called the CDA, the drag coefficient times the area. The lower this value is, the lower the drag will be overall as well. Because as a result of that, the only thing that the drag will then be proportional to after that is the dynamic pressure. So they've even tapered the roof here to reduce the drag. And they've also tapered the rear here. So they've not only made the rear small in the height-wise direction, but also the width-wise direction by taking in the sides here. So a lot has gone into making this car very low drag. Now, let's go on to this final picture here. And this is probably the most interesting picture because it shows us a lot of details that are very minor and actually people skip over them a lot because they are so difficult to see. You need to get the right angle to see them. But first of all, let's look at the wheel. We can see that both the front and rear wheels, they are kind of covered. Like, they look like they're not covered, but if you look at it from the side, there's this gleam to them. So that means that they do have like this plastic or glass shield over the top of them. But they do have this illusion of spokes. This means that the rims are completely covered, which is very good for reducing drag. In fact, doing this alone will reduce the drag of the wheels by about 25 counts or so. And you can see in this picture also the bleed here, that sort of exit here that the wheelhouse flow goes through to then mix into the rest of the flow, and also the air curtain. So the wheels have very aerodynamic rims. One problem with these rims is, though, because there is no opening, no cooling flow can get through here into the brakes. So from a functional point of view, and even from a safety point of view, these are not ideal. They're just aerodynamic. Like, this car has been bred to be aerodynamic and look good. It's not really that functional in terms of everyday life and safety. So the rims have been covered for that reason. Now, if we look at the wheels even more, we see that there are front wheel spoilers and rear wheel spoilers, but they are quite small. And this is for a good reason, for two reasons. First of all, you don't really need to have these spoilers that big. So what these spoilers do is the flow comes along, and instead of hitting the tires straight on, they actually hit these spoilers and then sort of move around the tire a little bit, which also reduces the drag. If you have these spoilers bigger, you're really just deflecting a lot more of the flow that you don't really need to deflect. But in addition to that, they are small because if you look at the tires, you can actually see from this angle how narrow they are. And this is actually a very important point that, as I said, you need to have the right angle in this picture to actually notice this. So you see how narrow these tires are, and there's actually an objective way of telling how narrow they are. So you see there are three longitudinal grooves on each of these tires. The longitudinal grooves are the grooves that go around the tire. And for a regular tire, like pretty much 99% of tires that you get, there are four grooves or five grooves, usually four grooves. That's like the most popular and common tire configuration. Now, these tires have only three longitudinal grooves, which means that they are much narrower as well. So our sight is being confirmed by the lack of the additional groove. Having a narrower wheel reduces the drag as well. In this particular case, with all the setup, it's probably by about 5 counts or so, but they can be up to like 10, 15, even 20 counts if you get very narrow wheels. And in terms of the availability of these tires, they're actually quite difficult to get. Like, the only cars that I'm really aware of that have potentially to have narrow tires are the BMW i3, and also I think a couple of Hyundais that have the similar sort of modeling to that. So I think that maybe these tires are actually especially made for this car, because these rims are so big, and like the BMW i3, even though they do have quite large rims, I don't think they're as big as these rims. So I think these tires were especially made just for this purpose, to be so narrow and so tall. So you couldn't really put these any other tires or rims probably onto this car, because of the wheelhouse wouldn't accommodate them. And the final and this, as I mentioned, reduces the drag. And the final drag reduction method that we're looking at here today is, if you look at the underbody, I should mention that I couldn't find any pictures clearly of the underbody, but I found some schematics, and they did kind of show that the underbody was flat. That's good for reducing drag as well, because you don't have nearly as many of these features poking out to turbulate the flow. The flow stays nicely attached, so when it hits the diffuser, it can do its job. But if you also look at the car at the front, it seems to be a lot lower to the ground than as you go to the rear wheels. It's a bit higher from the ground. So what this means is the car is kind of angled down a little bit, which also helps effectively make the entire underbody from start to end of the car one really big diffuser, if you think about it. And then when you get to the rear, then you really get that diffuser kicking in with the extendable feature as well. So that is another drag reduction feature. So that is how this car is reducing drag, and it's a really nice car. The engineers have done a really nice job in terms of making it very low drag, but also looking good. And if you like this video, make sure to like it and click the subscribe button. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace out, amigos.